Hey, VOUS Kids, we're so excited to see you today. Welcome back for another amazing Sunday. My name is Miss Lauren and I'm here with the beautiful Miss Jam. We are so happy to see you.
So excited for Sunday, but Miss Lauren, I think we need a warm up. Like, I'm a little cold.
Yeah.
I don't think I'm ready.
That's
for
a good idea.
Lessons today. Like, I think we need to do a little warm up. So, I want you standing up to your feet and you're gonna follow me, all right? So first, we're gonna stretch our arms. Stretch it, one, two, three. Then you're gonna switch, one, two, three. Then I think we need to stretch our legs. So you're gonna hold your leg, you have to hold your balance. One, two, three, you got it. Okay, switch. One, two, three. Okay, now I think we need to do something to get our body going.
Okay.
So I think we should do jumping jacks, but we need to spell out VOUS Kids.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's gonna be fun. Okay, on the count of three. One, two, three.
VOUS Kids.
Ooh.
Wow, that was a lot.
I think we're ready.
You think we're good? Okay. I think we are too. And every week we start our day off with the most amazing VOUS Kid values.
That's right. So starting off, VOUS Kid value number one, listening ears.
That's right. I will listen twice as much as I speak.
That's right. VOUS Kid value number two, kind mouth.
I will use kind words to honor others and speak life.
I love that, Ms. Lauren. Mm-hmm. We speak life here in VOUS Kids. VOUS Kid value number three, helping hands.
That's right. I'll use my hands for helping and sharing.
I love that. VOUS Kid value number four, humble heart.
Humble heart. I will think of others before myself.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And last but not least, VOUS Kid value number five, positive attitude.
Yeah, show us those smiles because I will always choose joy.
I love that, Ms.
Yeah. So good. I love our VOUS Kid values because we don't just use them here,
right,
but we use them at home, at school, in the park, with our friends. Doesn't matter where we are, we can always be using our VOUS Kid values.
Yeah, I love that so much. But I think it's time for us to get ready to worship.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm excited for worship. I think everybody needs to get up on their feet, get moving a little bit because we are going to go into worship.
We love you.
glorious way. I'm stepping out on your word. What's up, legends? Man, we just had a great time worshiping together. And now you know what time it is. We're going to be going over our memory verse for this month. Come on, it's my favorite time. We're learning new biblical verses to put into our hearts so we can always have with us. And today, we're going to be in Philippians 4:7. Why don't you say that with me? Philippians 4:7. Come on, I'm going to go through it. We got some fun hand motions. We're going to break it down. Then we're going to do it all together right before we go into our lesson. You guys ready? I can't hear you. You guys ready? All right, let's do it. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:7. You guys got it? You can break it down. I'll go slower. You guys ready? And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. You guys got that? The hand motions, we got the guarding of the hearts, we got the mind, we've got God, we got the peace signs. I think we're ready to do it all together now. So wherever you are, maybe stand up, get some room, spread out. If you're at home, if you're at Silver Spot, if you're, you know, with your friends and your parents, get them involved in it too. Let's do it all together. This month's memory verse, Philippians 4:7, it goes, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. Amen. Great job. You guys absolutely smashed it. I'm really fired up for today's lesson. So let's get ready to learn. What's up, legends? Come on. We're excited. We're about to learn through the Bible together. My name is Justin. I'm here with BZB. Oh my God, AKA the best kids teacher in the whole wide world. Blair, how are you doing today?
I'm doing so good. How are you doing, Jay?
I am doing so, so good. I'm excited to be here today.
Me too.
We were just talking about like the lesson we're going to learn today might be the best lesson ever in kids history.
I think it's the best lesson. I'm so excited. There's so much to learn today. And legends, guess what? Guess what, Jay?
What?
It's a new month.
New month.
Oh my goodness. It's a new month right here in Legends. I'm so excited. Last month, we talked all about joy.
That's right. The joy.
The joy of the Lord. And this month.
What's it about?
Can you guess, Mr. Justin? I'll give you some hints.
Yeah, give me a hint. Give me a hint. So is it all about the peace?
Peace.
Peace. I like that.
It was the peace sign.
So. Everybody should put your peace signs up.
Your peace signs up.
Flash it around.
So we're learning about peace. So cool because we've really been learning about how Jesus gives us joy.
That's right.
How Jesus gives us peace, how he gives us strength,
yeah.
So many things. But this month, all month long, we get to talk about how Jesus gives us peace.
Amen.
I am so excited to dive into the lesson today. Mr. Justin, we need to get warmed up a little bit. I know we just did worship in our memory verse.
I feel a little stiff.
I think like maybe we've got some legends that are kind of sitting there and maybe they're not listening quite yet. So we gotta like get their attention.
Right,
you know?
I agree.
Everybody's blood flowing a little bit. So what do you think we should do?
Because I feel like everybody now is feeling like a robot.
Yeah.
I think we gotta like, we're at a robot right now. Everyone get the robot going. Get your robot going. And we gotta loosen it up. Go loosen it up.
Oh.
Loosen it up. Keep loosening it up. Maybe get your legs involved, get your hips involved, start swaying around. We were a robot, but now we're swaying.
Now we're slinky.
Now we're slinky. And you know what? I feel a lot better now.
Me too.
I don't feel like
I'm
a
ready.
Robot.
I like it. I like it, Mr. Justin.
Oh, come on.
I'm super pumped for today. Feeling good now that I got the blood flowing.
Woo!
And I'm excited to dive into the lesson, but we always pray first.
Yes, we do.
Justin, you want to pray for us?
I would love to pray with all of us together. So wherever you are, if you're watching with friends, with your family, why don't you close your eyes? You can be praying with us. Don't let us pray alone.
Yes.
Everyone's gonna close their eyes and we'll pray. God, thank you so much for this opportunity. Thank you for the opportunity to be together, God, for the amazing friendships that we have in Legends together, for our amazing friends and family, God. We're grateful for you, Jesus. We're grateful for VOUS Church, we're grateful for VOUS Kids, and we're really excited and we're expecting so much to learn today in our amazing lesson. All the amazing VOUS Kid Legends said, amen.
Amen. Well, legends, we are kicking off this month's collection.
Kicking off.
Justin, we got a lot to cover today. So we're going to jump right into it and give you a full recap of the story. And guess who we're learning about today, legends? Two brothers.
Two brothers.
They're twins.
They're twins.
Does anybody know their names?
They're twins.
We've learned about them before in Legends. Can you shout it out if you know? Mr. Justin, do you know?
Jacob and Esau.
Jacob and Esau.
Man, I love the Old Testament.
Right, Mr. Justin. And I heard some Legends out there shouting out Jacob and Esau as well. Great job, Legends. Today, we're going to be talking about Jacob and Esau. So what's pretty cool, Mr. Justin, is this story is found in the book of Genesis.
First book.
The very first book of the Bible.
Yes. Really early on.
First book of the Bible, we learn about Jacob and Esau. Okay, so Legends, you guys know that we learned all about Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Abraham couldn't have a son.
Right.
Finally had a son. He was the one who went to sacrifice his son, Isaac.
Mm-hmm.
And God said, stopped him and said, no, you don't have to sacrifice him. You've trusted me.
Right.
You've given your life to me.
Right.
And so pretty cool story is we see Abraham.
Right.
Then we see Isaac.
It's like a family tree.
Yes. And then Isaac has the two boys, Jacob and Esau.
Wow, that's amazing.
Isn't that cool?
That's really, really cool.
You have a twin brother?
I have an older brother, but not a twin brother.
Wow.
So twin, like they're born together.
The same day.
They're the same age.
Same age. Pretty.
And are there any twins out there in VOUS Kids?
I bet there are some twins out there, huh? Cool. I know. It would be cool to be a twin. So they're twin brothers. They grow up together.
Right.
They have Isaac as their dad. Really cool.
He
is like such an awesome guy that we hear about to this day. We learn about him in the Bible.
Right.
And he's their dad. So they grow up together. They're having fun. Justin?
I have a question.
Yeah.
Me and my brother, like we used to fight. Do they get along as twins?
So they're very different. The Bible tells us in Genesis. It says that Esau, he loves to hunt. He loves to be outside.
He's a big, strong guy.
Yeah, he's like big.
Hairy.
Hairy. Oh my goodness.
Like hair everywhere.
He's hairy. He's got hair everywhere. Oh my goodness. Can you imagine?
Keeps warm.
Keeps him warm because he loves to be outdoors. And Jacob, they say he loves to be indoors.
Yeah.
Hanging out with his mom. Mm. Just
skinnier,
talking. Yeah.
Smaller.
Are you describing yourself?
Is he me?
Maybe. He's a lot like you. Do you like to be inside?
Love to be inside. AC?
Yes.
Who doesn't like that?
Air conditioning.
Food?
So, food. So they were very different, Mr. Justin. One of them liked to be outside.
Yeah.
One of them liked to be inside
a
lot of the times, eating food. So, crazy thing is, Mr. Justin, Esau, he was the older brother, actually.
Mm.
Even though they're twins, Esau was born first. And so from Isaac, there was this blessing that Isaac was going to give to the firstborn Esau.
So even though they're twins, Esau's the firstborn, so Isaac would give him the blessing.
Yes, he would get the blessing. He would get the blessing for his family, for his life, for his job. He was going to bless everything that Esau did.
I can imagine that like Jacob would want that blessing.
Yeah, can you imagine being the other brother? You're probably like, oh, I would want that too.
I wonder if you get like.
So listen to what happens.
Oh, is this like a dramedy? What's going on?
Yeah.
It's a comedy and a drama.
Yep. So listen, so Isaac, he's gotten so old that he really can't see anymore.
Mm.
Oh my goodness, Legends. So that's crazy. He's not able to see anymore. He can't even tell which one of his sons is. It would be crazy. It'd be like that, right, Mr.
Justin? My goodness. I don't have my glasses on. I can barely
see. That's how you feel, right? He didn't have his glasses on, so he feels that way already. So their dad's getting old where he is not able to see anymore. And so he's going to give the blessing, but he really can't tell which one of his sons is Jacob and which one's Esau. But the only way you can tell is just by touching him because Esau's
like
hairy.
Like
your senses.
Yeah.
So touching and smelling. And so guess what Jacob decides to do, Mr. Justin?
I have a feeling like, does he try to dress up as Esau? Like what's his goal here?
So really crazy, Legends. Listen to this. So Isaac sends Esau out to grab some food to bring back to make for him. And then when he says, once he comes back that he's going to bless him. But Jacob and his mom hear about this, and they go out first, and they come back with the food.
Wow.
And Jacob dresses up as Esau, puts on his clothes so he can smell like him, puts on all kinds of stuff so he can be hairy, and he goes into his dad and pretends like he's Esau. Can you imagine that, Mr.
I am That's kind of crazy. So he literally disguised himself as his brother so he can steal the blessing from his older brother.
Right.
Crazy. Listen, all I want to know is I do not want to be Jacob when Esau finds out. Because he's a big, strong guy.
He likes to be outside in the woods.
That's not something I want to mess with.
I know. Legends, can you believe that? Wow, that is pretty crazy.
My goodness.
And listen to this, Legends. Isaac gives the blessing to Jacob, thinking that he's Esau. Oh my goodness, Mr. Justin. Guess what happens?
It's like a blessing. Like, once you give it, you can't get it back.
Yeah.
Like, now he has it.
He has the blessing. And guess who finds out?
Don't tell me Esau finds out.
Don't tell me Esau finds out. And Esau starts crying. The Bible says that he starts crying because he wants the blessing. And Isaac says, I can't take back the blessing. Jacob is now blessed. And you will be serving Jacob all of your life. This is pretty crazy
stuff, Mr. Imagine Jeffrey. From going to like firstborn, you're digging to be blessed. And all of a sudden, your whole life changes.
Whoa.
The 180.
Okay. So Legends, listen in. We just talked about a lot of things.
Yeah.
We talked about Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Esau.
The twins.
Jacob steals Esau's blessing.
That's right.
You with us, Legends? Can
Still
you
there.
Shout yes if you're with us? We hear
Got
you.
It. Got
okay,
it.
You're with us. So pretty crazy. Esau finds out. He freaks out. He says, oh my goodness. He says that he wants to hurt his brother because he's so mad. Woo, that's scary.
My brother's hurt me before.
Oh yeah.
Good old fashioned
beating.
Not
be fun. Ew. So Jacob leaves.
Yeah.
He leaves. He goes to live with his uncle.
Mm.
And he goes to live with his uncle, Mr. Justin.
For how long?
For like 20 years.
So like 20 years passed. Like
20 years.
Now they're like adults.
They're older.
They're old.
They're adults. Jacob gets married. He's living there for 20 years. He hasn't seen his family. He has not seen Esau the whole time. So he was so scared that he ran away for 20 years. Can you believe that?
That's amazing.
That's
crazy.
Crazy, Mr. Justin. How would you feel?
They have kids now.
Yeah.
They're adults. I feel like Jacob still thinks that Esau's going to beat him up.
Probably so. I think so. And actually, the Bible says that Jacob heads back after 20 years, and he does. He's afraid.
Wow.
He's praying. He's hoping that Esau would not hurt him when he comes back. And guess what happens, Mr. Justin, when Jacob comes back and sees Esau after 20 years?
So, I mean, what I would expect to happen is that Esau runs up and just like tackles him and a big fight breaks out. But, you know, I'm kind of thinking about the story and our theme for the month, Miss Blair, and it's kind of crazy, but I have a feeling that Esau's going to forgive him.
Mr. Justin, you are right.
Mike.
Isn't that crazy?
I don't know if I could do that.
Okay, so the Bible says that Jacob comes back and Esau comes and gives him a huge hug. He embraces him. Pretty crazy. And in that moment, he forgave him. He
Jacob,
had already forgiven
Jacob must be shocked.
Jacob is definitely
He's
shocked.
He's like, whoa, it's the bear hug.
Wow, crazy, right? And what's really cool about this story is there's so many things that happened. 20 years of them not seeing each
That's
other.
Right.
But Esau had forgiven him. And that forgiveness gave Jacob a peace now.
That's right.
And I love the story because we're talking about the peace of the Lord, the peace of God. And we're talking about in this story how Jacob, he came home and he found peace at home because Esau forgave him. Of course, Jacob did something very wrong.
Yeah.
But he got Esau's forgiveness because he was his brother.
Come on.
And he asked for his forgiveness. And Esau gave it to him. And what's really beautiful is that this reminds me of another story, Mr. Justin. It reminds me of Jesus' forgiveness.
Okay.
Do you know a little bit about Jesus' forgiveness?
I mean, I'm just thinking about, you know, we know about Jesus. We know about this story. It's amazing how all the stories that we've been reading in the Old Testament, it always leads us to Jesus.
Yep.
Like, these are all the things that Jesus came and taught about forgiveness. And really, the most important forgiveness that we've ever had is that Jesus has forgiven every single one of our sins.
Yep.
You know, whether we deserve it or not, it's this amazing thing called grace. But forgiveness is really where it starts. It's forgiveness that allows us to learn more about Jesus.
Yes.
But I think it's forgiveness that leads to peace.
Yes, it does. There's so many things that can allow us to have peace in our lives. But the biggest thing is that we have Jesus' forgiveness.
Come on. It's amazing.
And what's beautiful is that we get to live that out and we get to forgive other people in our life. Like how Esau forgave someone else and give other people peace in their lives through forgiveness. And today, legends, we're talking about peace and we're talking about forgiveness.
That's right.
Maybe you're listening today and you would say, I haven't experienced the forgiveness of Jesus. I haven't allowed him to wash away my sins.
Wow.
Jesus, he forgives you of all of your sins and he wants relationship with you, legends. You know that you can walk with him, you can talk with him, that you can become more like him every day.
Amazing.
Someone that lives with joy, someone that lives with peace, and you can become more like him each and every day just by choosing to follow him. And there's an easy way in legends that we make this decision to walk with Jesus,
right,
and have a relationship with him. And really, it's pretty special because in the Bible, it says, if we declare with our mouth and believe in our hearts, we will be saved.
That's right.
So it's just as simple as that. It's just that easy, legends. We just have to declare it with our mouth and believe in our hearts that Jesus, he lives in us. What's beautiful is he came to die for us.
Amen.
He came to die for us so that he could wipe away all of our sins. And he rose from the dead. That means he was dead and he came alive again,
it's
legends.
Incredible.
So that we could live in eternity with him. So we get to live in eternity with him if we believe in our hearts and confess with our mouths. How cool is that, Mr.
That is amazing. Just like Ms. Blair was saying, that every single week here in Legends, we want to give people the opportunity to make that amazing decision.
Yes.
And I love how every time we make this decision, there's a party up in heaven and we celebrate together. So for right now, we're gonna give you the opportunity to make this decision wherever you are for the first time. You can do this when you're at home, at school right now, wherever you are watching. If you pray this prayer with us and you raise your hand and you believe in your heart, man, you are with Jesus, you are
saved.
And it's really incredible that we get to do this together every single week. So wherever you are, we're gonna pray together. You can close your eyes, you can bow your head and pray with me. On the count of three, when I say three, you can raise your hand. But one, right now, this is a decision you make by yourself. You don't have to look around to your parents or to your friends. Two, you can make the decision right now. You don't have to wait till you're older. You don't have to wait till next week. And three, you can raise your hand right now if you want to accept Jesus into your life. We're going to pray this prayer together so you can repeat after me. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
I love you.
I love you.
I am thankful.
I am thankful.
That you died on the cross.
That you died on the cross.
And rose again.
And rose again.
And forgave me.
And forgave me.
Of all of my sins.
Of all of my sins.
I give you my past.
I give you my past.
I give you my present.
I give you my present.
I even place my future in your hands.
I even place my future in your hands.
I'm all yours, Jesus.
I'm all yours, Jesus.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Come on, there's a party in heaven.
Woo!
The angels
are excited, rejoicing. Mr.
We're dancing
Justin.
Over here.
We're throwing a
party.
Such a good Sunday.
Ain't no party like a Legends party.
Ain't no party like a Legends
party.
We're throwing a party for you, Legends. Such a special day learning about Jacob, Esau, the peace of God through his forgiveness. The peace of God through his forgiveness. I love it. We're so excited that we get to continue learning about peace all month long.
All month.
But today we've got Kids Cruise, Mr. Justin.
Kids Cruise.
Got Kids Cruise. You got to check it out.
I can't wait.
On Zoom.
I'm going to be there.
I'm going to be there too, Mr. Justin.
There.
I can't wait. We love you, Legends. We'll see you next time.
Come on.